for a library of 400 full-length yoga and HIIT classes, plus ongoing new classes and schedules weekly, come to my website at alikamenova.com and join my membership. Namaste, beautiful yogis. This is going to be a quick coffee cup class. Let's begin. Starting at the front of the mat, inhale your hands over the head, bring them over the heart. Inhale them out, fingertips reaching away from each other. Pull the belly in, activating the deep abdominal muscles. Press into all four corners of each foot, really allowing your feet to begin sinking into the mat and at the same time elongating the spine through the crown of the head up. So you're feeling all these forces working in five different directions through the fingertips, through the feet, and through the head. Reaching, expanding, feeling the energies of the body, tuning into the energies of the body. Nice deep inhalations, followed by complete exhalations. Shifting your weight onto your right leg, take the left leg back all the way to Warrior Three. Bend the right knee, step your left leg back to Warrior One. Reaching over the head. Open Warrior Two. Reverse it. Side angle. Right hand on the floor. Reaching over the head. Look down. Take your left hand to the floor. Right arm up. Revolving half moon. Power up the right leg. Come up, Warrior Three, back up to standing, shifting onto the left leg. Warrior Three, airplane the arms or Superman the arms out. Step it back, Warrior One. Easy, fluidly moving here. You don't have to go to a really deep pose, just easing into the practice. Warrior Two, reverse it. Side angle. Look ahead of you. Shift to half moon. Lift into Warrior Three. Step it back to the front. Shift onto the right side. Superman Warrior Three. Level the hips. Warrior One. Warrior Two. Reverse it. This time straighten the right knee. Triangle pose. Easy. Look down, bend the right knee, and we're gonna do a few little steps or one big to revolving half moon. To Warrior Three, balancing. Balancing today, step it down, shifting, Superman Warrior Three. Warrior Two, Warrior One, sorry. Virabhadrasana Two, Warrior Two. Reverse it, right hand down the right leg. Straighten the leg. Triangle pose. Try to take the tailbone under here. So if you look at the screen, I don't know how well it's showing here, but if you don't tuck your tailbone, you'll be like, a little crooked, such as what I'm showing. When you tuck it under, everything gets in the same plane or intends to do that. All right, bending the front knee, get your balance working and transition one shift if you can, if not, no big deal. Two, revolving half moon. To warrior three. We can do it. Level the hips. Come up to standing. Let's go third round. Shifting onto the right side. Superman warrior three. This time, instead of warrior one, we're gonna do high lunge. Bend the right knee, step back, high lunge, and jump your right foot up five times. One, two, three, four, five. Now jump the left foot five times. One, two, three, four, five. Excellent. Hands in prayer, twist. Release the left hand on the inside of the right foot. Roll onto the outer edges of both feet. Sit into your right hip. Feel the hip opening. Grab the big toe, right big toe with your right hand. Yogic hold and open here. Release. We're gonna do toe touches. 10 of them. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Opposite foot, now left foot to right hand. One, two, extend in between touches. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and ten. From here, glide your left foot forward, bring both hands on the floor, and allow this stretch here, gliding on the upper edge of the left foot and finding a stretch in the hip here. Very good. Step your left foot out now and feel that hip opening. Think of it as a dancer's pose. You're really feeling it and feeling your hip in it. There is no particular place you need to be in here. That's not a square masculine pose. That's a very feminine dance pose. Just feeling the fluidity of the body. You can bring the spine into this and move. A few more of those, tippy toes. Great, let's bring a little bit of masculinity. The yang element, push up. One, two, three. Step it back first. Plank. Hold it. And shift it forward and back. Shifting your plank. Forward and back. Forward and back. Forward and back. Great. Jump your feet between your hands. Exhale. First forward fold. Inhale, come up to standing. We're totally reversing the order of how we do things because that's always a good thing to break up the attachment to poses. Alright, shifting onto the left leg, warrior three. Level the hips, turn the toes down, flex the foot on the right side. Step it back to high lunge, five jumps with the left foot. One, two, three, four, five. Five with the right. One, two, three, four, five. Hands in prayer, twist. Right hand on the inside of the left foot.
Roll onto the outer edges of your feet and feel that hip opening, left hip. In this case, yogic, hold, big toe, lift, release, and we're gonna go for toe touches. One, left hand, left foot. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, opposite side, right foot, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10, bring both hands down on the floor, glide your right foot across from your body, feel that stretch. Feel it in your right hip. It should feel amazing. Something needed. Step your right foot out and feel now that the hip opener onto your toes and just feel the hip fluidly opening. Moving the hips. Beautiful. Hands in push up. One push up. Two. Three. Step it back. Plank. Now we're gonna go for a coffee cup interval. Which is also a plank interval, and I'll demonstrate the first rep. Feel free to follow along or just join after the first rep. We'll go one, jumping the feet in, two, jumping closer, three, jumping the knees between the elbows, and then reverse it, three small jumps. One, keeping the knees off the mat, two, three, to plank. So let's do five of them and then I'll tell you then. One, two, knees just off the floor. Three, reverse one, two, three. One. Two. This is challenging. Four, one more for good measure, all right, come back to plank. Going to jump the feet on the outside of the hands. Come up, squat jump, keep your booty back. Back to push up, forward. Back to push up. You can do a star push up, jump the feet back, jump them out, push up, and jump them forward. Let's do five of those. I hear my baby talking, so when she calls me, I'll go bring her and she'll join us for the rest of the coffee cup. So, really ready to go. Jump back, star push up, low squats. Two. Ooh. Three. Keeping the squats low is where it is at. Four. Really hurts. Five. Okay. plank, hold it. Hold it to knee tucks. Knee tucks with a circle. So circle the right knee. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, down dog. You deserve a down dog. Nice deep inhalations followed by complete exhalations. Take your right leg to the front of the mat. Come up and we're gonna do just a few side lunge squats. Take your feet a little wider than hip width apart. And we're gonna go for 3 surfers. 1, 2, 3. Hands on the ground. Jump it back. Push up. Step it forward. 3 more. 1, 2, 3. Push up. 1, 2, 3. Push up. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. One, two, three. Three more. 1, 2, 3. That's 1, 2 more. 1, 2, 3. That's 2. 1, 2, 3. That's 3. And come back up for side out face, side squat lunges, just shifting side to side. Now reaching side to side. Now reaching over the head, over the head, over the head, over the head. All right, plank. Take the right knee between your elbows. Step the right foot across. Side plank. 2. Tabletop. Let's drop the left hand down. Turn the fingers on the right side forward and we're gonna do 5 jumps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to 4 jump ups, single leg. 1, 2, alternating, 3, 4, reverse it to plank, step it back, left knee between the elbows. Step it across, tabletop, 5 jumps, 1, 2, 3, 4, keep your hips as lifted as you can for 5, 4 jumps with the legs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, reverse it, step it back, right knee in, step it through. 5 jumps, 1, keep the hips lifted, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4 jumps, 1, 2, 3, 4, I was gonna keep going, but opposite side, let's go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, quickly. Last round, quickly moving. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Last one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Woo. That's a booty killer. 2 pigeon on the right side. Not a long pigeon, this is a coffee cup after all. Lift your chest, breathe very slowly. Opposite side, stretching in motion. Although you may think that doesn't work, it does. Trust me. Short stretching is what I was talking about. You may think, oh, why are we not lingering? Because there is a way to stretch through holding and a way through movement. And not one of those ways is more effective than the other. They're both different and they keep you agile and flexible. All right, start plank jumps. Step it back. And we're going to jump the feet 5 times on the outside. We're only counting the feet outside of the mat as 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Jump your feet to the front. 1, 2, 3, 4. Keep it low. But otherwise it's cardio, but it's not booty. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Belly in. 1, 2, 3. This is overly. 5. Last one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Jump it to the front low. 1. If you're able to do this, you're not doing it right. 2, 3. Straight back. Please straight back. 4, 5. And my thighs are officially dead. Since they're dead, let's sit back in chair. Tuck your tailbone under. Hands in prayer. Bring your right hand to your left thigh. Look down. Make sure that your knees are together. Opposite side. One more side to the right elbow to the left. Or yes, take the right leg back, twist lunge, step it to the front, opposite side. Step it to the front, squat down in a squat, and sit down. Soles of the feet together. Don't be afraid to breathe. All right, forward bend. Press your toes back. Forward bend. Wide-legged forward bend. Booty back, knees up, flex your feet. Extend the right leg down, right arm up, left leg bent, twist, and either just stay here or clasp under. Keep your right leg very active. Shoulders back and down. You can lift your left leg off the floor. Okay, back down, change sides. Clasping optional. Open here, look over the shoulder. Release. One more forward bend. We're going to lower down onto the floor. Lean star. So your feet are, legs are out, arms are out, and we're going to touch opposite hand to toe. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 to a supine twist, right knee in and across, shoulder down, look away from you. Opposite side. Knees into the chest. Twist or draw circles with your knees. Opposite side. Soles of the feet together. Lay down, reclining bound angle. And let's bring the hands underneath on the side of the legs to bring the legs together. Here we're gonna come up and go for a twist. Soles of the feet down on the ground, hands behind you or to the side depending on your twistability level. Forehead coming down to the floor, opposite side. This is a full spinal twist. Lower down and relax here for a few moments. Allowing yourself to come back to your breath and to the sensation of being you. Allowing yourself to fully be immersed in that sensation of being you. A particle in the universe, a particle of the universal one, but being fully you. Being your creative fire, your creative particle, soul, self. Envisioning yourself laying in a lush field of grass and flowers, and as if you're weightless, floating, all surrounded by that lush grass and flowers in the safety of the hug of the hold of Mother Earth, being caressed by the sunlight. Feeling the sunlight on your skin is this gentle caress. Feeling the light, warm rays on your skin. Feeling the movement of the flowers and grasses around you. Feeling the freshness of the air, the warmth of the sun, the stability of the earth underneath you, holding you, being there for you, nurturing you, protecting you, while your heart is free to be playful, creative, giving. Exuberant, excited, generous, loving. keeping that feeling of safety, liveliness, playfulness. Joy for the mind, soul, body. Lightness, that feeling of lightness because we're safe, protected, nurtured, and there is room for growth and expression and joy and playfulness. Feeling that sense, feeling, and we're keeping preserving that feeling and sensation. Slowly begin to move your toes and fingers. And bring yourself back to the room you're occupying, that you're currently in. Feel the floor underneath you and the sensation of the air on your skin. Holding that feeling that we just created in your heart. Let's bring the hands over the heart, palms down towards your skin, towards your heart. Keeping that feeling in, bringing it in. Great, let's roll onto our right side. Use your left hand to press yourself up to sit it. If you can keep your eyes closed, keep them closed. Rock a little bit here, sitting in easy pose. Just rock gently and easy, however it feels good to rock. Inhale your hands out to the sides and bring them over the heart as if you're scooping air and whatever prana or whatever is in the air and bringing it into the heart. And again, scooping in and scooping air in and breathe it all in, feeling full of that sensation, generously taking, ready to generously give as you go into your day. Let's inhale the hands over the head, over the third eye for always seeing the truth. Over the throat for always speaking the truth, expressing yourself. And over the heart. Let's bow to our hearts for their forgiveness, compassion, and love. Namaste.